Hey, what's up guys? Alex here. If you've been following along, then you know what's coming. Also, you probably read the title, and I didn't lie. Today, we're putting drums on this puppy. Okay, let's get into it. Okay, so you probably recognize this piece. Well, maybe you know it. I've changed it a little bit since the last video, which was recording guitar on top of the pad that we made in the video before that. I've actually gone and re-performed a bunch of this guitar because I realized that I was clipping somewhere and it just sounded like total crap. And so this is what I came up with. Let's just have a quick listen. Okay, desperately in need of some drums, but you can definitely tell that I've made some changes. First of all, I turned it up 20 beats per minute up to 100, and I've spread these out a little bit, so I figure the drums will come in around here where it starts to get a little more poppy, a little more funky, and this will just kind of be an intro. I'm thinking later on we'll do something, we'll add maybe another pad, maybe an arp or something like that, but in this video let's just do some drums. Okay. So what are some considerations when recording drums? Well, there's really two main ways to record drums, just like anything else. You can perform them or you can draw them in. And by that I mean if you perform them, it could be from your laptop keyboard, from a MIDI keyboard, from like drum pads that you might have. It could be a real acoustic kit in a drum room with all the microphones set up and plugged into Bitwig. We're not going to do that today. I have my drum pads plugged in, which are attached to my MIDI keyboard, and we'll use that. So that being said, we're going to need a MIDI drum machine. So click the plus sign here, click Bitwig, let's go and click drum machine. And now let's just work off a preset for now. Let's not worry too much about the sounds. If you've set up a 128, and you watch that video and you've gone and set that up, you should probably use the 128. I'm not going to assume that you've gone and set up a 128, but you totally should if you haven't yet. It's worth it. It's 100% worth it. But in this one, let's just use the drum machine, click presets, and let's choose, this is a good one, the DW2, which is a classic acoustic kit. So let's hear. Okay, so that's working on my drum pad. So if we're going to draw it in, you could just double click there, create an empty MIDI region. And then of course, like anything, you can press 3 and you can draw in the pieces. Okay, I'm going to perform them today because you can go in and easily draw these in yourself if you don't want to use, if you don't want to perform them. If you don't have a MIDI keyboard or drum pads, you can easily use your laptop keyboard. Just hit caps lock. And there we go. As you kind of go through the A, S, D, F, G buttons. And even the QWERTY. You can perform it just like as if you had drum pads. Okay, but I actually have drum pads, so I'm going to use those. So I'm going to delete that. Other considerations are, if you press command comma or you go up here, is the buffer size. Remember, we're performing now and we're performing MIDI, so it doesn't need to quite be so low. I found for my computer, my CPU and everything, 512 samples wasn't too bad, but you just don't want to have it all the way up there. Remember, that's for editing, that's for performing. Okay, if you remember, you have to arm the track to tell Bitwig which track you're gonna arm or you're gonna record on, and you have to click the global record button. Another way to do that is to just hit F9, and then when you're ready and everyone's ready to perform, you just hit spacebar. Okay, let's look what we've done here. So you'll notice I didn't play all the way through, and that's because really I don't need to. I'm gonna double click this guy, and just drag it up. Notice how I have the fold button clicked. If I don't have fold on, like I have, there's no need for me to look at all this crap. So you click fold, and interestingly enough, Bitwig organizes it so that only the keys that are assigned to a sound are shown, okay? And they're even labeled, which is fantastic. So I'm gonna work on the clip here. Zoom out a little bit. And I'm just gonna highlight them all and press Q for quantize and see what effect that has. Not much. There we go. Sorry, I had caps lock left on. And actually that placed them exactly where I want them to go. So that's easy. That's good enough. Drag that back down. And I notice that I'm going over top here. You see that? Well, if I try to duplicate this piece, that's going to screw it up. So I now want this to fill in the gap here. And I can do that in a couple ways. I can click it and press Command D for duplicate. And that's easy enough. Or I can just go here. Notice how when I'm at the top of the region, it's just a bracket. When I go to the bottom of the region, it's got the little loop sign beside it. So I can click and drag that out too. And that's perfect because now I'm, see, I recorded three bars, which is awkward, right? I should have done four, but it doesn't really matter. Because I use that loop tool, I can drag it out as long as I want. And if you're gonna drag this out for like 90 bars throughout your whole song, for example, then that's definitely the way to do it rather than clicking Command D however many times, 60 times or whatever. Okay, so now I'm gonna separate this track because there's this, it's different here. This is still just a hi-hat just playing on the quarter note. And then this is where the beat actually comes in. So to separate this track, I'm gonna press Command E, okay? And I'm gonna click this and actually consolidate it because if you look down here, this clip, even though I'm on clips, has retained all this information on the outside of it. But I don't need this information. I have that in a separate clip. So I'm gonna do what's called consolidate it or Command J for join. And see now, when I click this clip, it's just what's inside this clip. Okay, I know it's a little bit confusing, but basically when you press Command J or join, you can merge a bunch of these together. So if I wanted to put these three together, highlight them all, Command J, and now they're one clip, which is what you should do before you do the final export of your song. But I don't want to do that. I wanted this separate. But see, now it's got this information on either side of the clip. This is the end of the clip, or right there. And this is the beginning of the clip, or right here. And it's got all this useless MIDI data that I don't really want. And it's not necessarily useless. If I accidentally delete that, I can drag it out, and it's called non-destructive editing, right? But that's not what I want for this clip. So I'm gonna hit Command J, click it, and there it is. I'm gonna highlight these guys and hit Q. Oh, perfect, all right. Quantize worked. All right, let's have a closer look at this. Again, I'm gonna hit Command J, click it again, and let's see. Let's take a closer look here. Let me clear up my screen. So Option I to get rid of that, and Shift Tab to make it full screen. Well, let's Shift Tab again. Let's have a listen. Almost. Few little mistakes. For example, I don't want that note or that one or this guy. Come on now. All right. To get that eraser tool, I just hit 4, by the way. Go back to 1. Now I'm gonna Command A to grab all the notes and hit Q. Let's see. Actually, that looks like it worked just the way that I wanted it to. Again, I think I recorded an awkward amount of bars. Let's just make that 2. Let's have a listen. Okay, so that worked. There's a little variation in that hi-hat, that open hi-hat, and it's because I wasn't hitting the drum pad as hard as I'm hitting all the rest. And that's just me having a pressure or velocity sensitive drum pads. But we can easily fix that. come down here to the velocity editor, and you can see how some of these I didn't hit as hard. So now I'm just going to grab the lowest one and slam it to the top. Now let's have a listen. All right, not bad. I noticed this one note needs to be dragged out. All right. Okay. Not bad. There's a few other things we need to do. It's not a very punchy kit, but let's expand that out by pressing Command D. And now, well, there's a few things we can do. We can actually layer this sound with a whole other drum kit, and why don't we give that a shot? So I'm going to click the plus sign. Actually, I'm just going to highlight this track and hit Command D and just duplicate it. I'm going to delete this stuff so that we have the same information on both tracks, but we're using the same kit. So you just double click on the track and we'll just change up the preset. Why don't we try one of those Yamahas and see how that sounds. Not bad. Let's layer it again. Command D, choose a different kit. I think we should choose an electronic kit this time. What does this guy sound like? I have to put, oh yeah, it's on. Let's try that. Let's see. Well, it's not perfect. I think I would want to get rid of that hi-hat in this sample. But for now, let's not forget to rename all these. And just for simplicity, I would probably name them something more distinguishable. Like, I should have called them drums DW, drums Yamaha, whatever. But for this case, let's highlight all these tracks, hit Command G for group, Command R to rename, and call it drums. Okay, so now we can swallow that up. And now the benefit of doing that is if I want to highlight this section and move it, or I want to copy it, I can just option click and drag it somewhere. And now I have a copy of all of those drums. See, that makes sense. And the same thing goes. Usually I'll take everything here, put it in a group, rename it everything. Okay, because now if I'm arranging the song, if this is the chorus, I can just highlight this section and duplicate the chorus as many times as I want. But that's besides the point. We'll get into that when we do the final touches on this song. So it sounds pretty weak right now. Do we have a reverb loaded up? We do have a reverb. Okay. I'm going to send this to the reverb. I'm going to do it independently, I think. Bring that up a bit. Bring that up a bit. Okay, not bad. You know what it's missing? If we listen to the transition, let's start here. Some kind of a build. And there's a couple ways you can make that happen. Probably the easiest way is to find the sample of, say, a crash, for example. Yeah, that one will do for now. And now, hide that window. Let's add a ton of reverb on this. Thank you. All right, that'll do. Click it, Command J, drag out this region for as long as you think that MIDI tail is gonna last. Right click, bounce. Okay, pre-fader, don't dither it. No need to do it in real time, you can if you want. Click OK. And there we go. Let's delete that. Now, you can click this and reverse it. So if you go up to clip, you can click, where is it, reverse, but I would say pin that up here. Okay, there we have it. Put this back. Now let's have a listen. Yeah. I'm gonna duplicate that and reverse it back. And it's gonna take a little bit to work it through. I won't do that on camera because that's tedious. It's just important to know that to get these rises, you can kind of just take interesting sounds, manipulate them how you want, reverse them again, anything like that. Okay, so other things that you should be aware of is the shrink by 50% or grow by 200%. And so that you can find it just in the clips here. And again, I pin this stuff. I pin the consolidate button up there, even though I'm used to hitting Command J, or I call it join. But I generally pin stuff up there just so that it's easy and for me to use, although I'm used to the quick commands by now. But say I want this to play in double time. I can click scale 50%. And now, we'll check this out. Okay. What if we're doing a breakdown? Let me take these three, expand them by 200%. See? So it's just quick little things like that. We'll speed up the process. If you're going to do a breakdown, try just scaling it to 200%. See how that sounds and work the MIDI that way. Okay, so off camera, I'm basically just going to work on this guy a little bit here. This is in serious need of some bass, some sub bass to come in, and I think that's what we'll do next before we do any final touches, as in adding in arps and things like that. Okay? All right, guys, take care.